We're in Norway now, and as we pass through the birch forest, we're most impressed with the autumn leaves. It's a sight you never see in Australia, but we don't really have any native deciduous trees. The drive is very spectacular. Now heading north along the coast, as ships would have done years ago. This is how Norway got its original name, Northway. Our destination today is the most northern point in Europe.
That's a good time to do.
Norklap. We crossed to an island, so technically we passed the northern mainland point. The cost of the tunnel is very expensive. I'm totally shocked on the return to pay the fee again. It's not like we have any choice. We are now approaching the latitude of 71 degrees and the small fishing town of Ollingsvåg. At these latitudes, the sun disappears completely beyond the horizon on the 20th of November, not returning again till the 22nd of January. Of course, from mid-May to July, the sun never sets. We are here in September. The road finally arrives at a huge tourist complex. We opt not to go in. For the true north point is 9 kilometres away and can only be reached on foot. This area is extremely popular in the summer. For most of the trip, we've had good weather, but today, driving over the mountain pass, we encounter snow, and it makes driving quite precarious with our off-road tyres. Eventually, the weather clears and we find a nice spot to camp by the river, and decide to spend another day there to dry out. Thank you. we arrive at the town of Alta to look at some petroglyphs along the shore. A museum and a World Heritage Site, it contains over 3,000 carvings. In this area, there are over 5,000, and they tell the story of human activity from about 4,000 to 500 BC. Many of the petroglyphs have been inlaid with red paint to make them clearer. They're originally carved using one stone as a chisel and another as a hammer. The rock carvings in Alta indicate that this was a religious meeting place. It also shows how, in the semi-religion, nature was regarded as possessing a soul and being alive. People have lived in Norway for about 11,000 years, mainly on the seaboard. As we head south, the road clings to the coast, the mountains coming right down to the sea. There is very little flat land here in Norway, and whenever there is, there's a house or a small town. Only 3% of Norway is usable. In the last 30 years, Norway has become the richest country in the world. When oil was found off the coast, they decided that rather than spend the money they made, they would invest it and only spend the interest. Their reasoning was that the revenue for the oil also belonged to their future generations as well. The next morning, it's a very cold start. Luckily, there's no wind, so it's not too bad. We are still well inside the Arctic Circle. We don't get this really cold weather in Australia. We're making a detour from the mainland and heading out along a string of islands known as the Lofotens. We head down to the town of A, which is simply spelt with the single letter A. Here we rent a cabin for a few days. It's a historic fishing village. In the winter, the warmer currents around the islands attract the Arctic cod here to breed. There have been people fishing here for thousands of years, and it's still the major industry today. This is some fish drying. The town clings to the rocks and is connected by a series of wooden footbridges. Back to the mainland again and heading south, we visit some more petroglyphs along the way. Not many, but still quite impressive. This is the bowler reindeer, a life-size carving that was done in the Stone Age period about 6,000 years ago. There's also a bear and a man on skis. We stop at Trondheim to resupply. I spot some serious inflatable boats. Heading inland now to Roos, a very historic copper mining town. The first smelter was built in 1646 and was a major revenue source for Norway in the 18th century. There are still some 2,000 people living in the town. Most of the buildings were built in the late 1700s. This is one of the typical cottages that the miners lived in. Notice how small they must have been. Tired of following the coast, we keep inland and across a range of mountains. It proves to be quite adventurous and takes us a lot longer than we expected. Thank you. We're heading for the town of Lillehammer, home of the 1994 Winter Olympics. Whilst the mountain scenery is certainly exceptional, I'm relieved to see the end of these icy, windy roads.
And how many shots do you want?
I need at least 200.
Dating from about 1150, the Urn Stave Church is the oldest of its kind in the country. It has some of the richest carvings of Norway's stave churches and is the only one to be recognised by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site. People have lived on this spot since prehistoric times, as evidenced by the three burial mounds discovered around the church. That night, we camp early in a nice forest, and I went looking to see if I could find any wildlife, maybe a few birds. But it was very quiet. In the next episode, we continue south. Take a cruise down Norway's largest fjord. Then on to Oslo. Then across through Sweden and on to Tampere, Finland, where we spend a day four-wheel driving in the local rubbish dump.